everyone, welcome to my schooling YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss about Indian economy 1950 to 1990, economics of class 12. If you didn't watch part 1 and part 2, link is given in the description box below. Let's get started. But before that, subscribe to my YouTube channel and press the bell icon. You will be notified every time. Follow me on Instagram, the link which is given in the description box below. Today we are going to discuss about trading policy. What do you mean by trading policy? It refers to the regulations and agreements that control imports and exports to foreign countries. In the first 7 5-year plans of India, the trade was commonly called an inward-looking trade strategy. It is also known as import substitution. Import substitution is a trade and economic policy which advocates replacing foreign imports with domestic production. It is based on the premise that a country should adapt to reduce its foreign dependency through the local production of industrialized products. That is, substituting imports. We are taking everything from the domestic. It is not being imported. Substituting imports with domestic production. Imports were protected by imposition of tariffs and quotas. There are two types of protection, tariffs and quotas. Tariffs are taxes or duties on imported goods designed to raise the price to the level or above the existing domestic price, and non-tariff barriers, which include all other barriers. Quota is a limit to the quantity coming into your country. Tariffs and quotas protect the domestic firms from foreign competition. Impact of inward-looking trade strategy on the domestic industry. It helped to save foreign exchange by reducing import of goods. It created a protected market and large demand for domestically produced goods, thereby inducing more amount of employment, and our resources are being used rather than importing from foreign countries. It helped to build a strong industrial base in our country, directly leading to economic growth. Criticism of import substitution. There is no proper growth, there is lack of competition, hence there is no modernization, growth of inefficient monopolies, there is no efficiency. Industrial Development and Resolution Act, IDRA. It was enacted in 1951. Its objectives are regulation with proper planning, avoidance of monopoly, balanced regional development to promote parity among all the states, prevention of undue competition between the large-scale industry and the small-scale industry, optimum utilization of scarce resources. Its criticisms are against industrial licensing. There is no proper ad hoc system for accepting or rejecting the license. Quality of technical economic examination is poor. Licensing policy resulted in underutilization. Large economic establishments flourished. There was no scope for the smaller economic industries. License Raj. Licenses and regulations that require to set up industries by the private sector as per IPR 1956. State fully controlled the private sector. Earlier days, if you see, to start up an industry or to expand the line of production, a private industry need to get permit license Raj from the government. On 15th August 1947, when India achieved independence, the country was grappling with problems of widespread poverty and crisis in agriculture as well as industries. The first 5-year plan was launched in 1951, which mainly focused on the development of the primary sector. 5 years later, on 14th May 1956, the second 5-year plan, famously known as the Mahalanobis model, was announced. The emphasis of this plan was on government-led industrialization. Mr. Nehru outlined the central role of the government when he said, "The public sector must grow not only absolutely but also relatively to the private sector." Thus started the license permit quota Raj in India, wherein government control was so strong that it not only decided which company would produce what, but also the amount of production as well as the price of commodities. With the nationalization of banks in 1969 and the Monopolies and Restrictive Trade Practices MRTP Act of 1970, the License Raj was further strengthened. Life under License Raj was characterized by scarcity of resources. The choices people had available to them in their day-to-day life was very limited. For example, cars were available only in one color and only two or three brands of cars or scooters existed in the market to choose from. The speciality of License Raj was that licenses were made themselves, made a commodity and a scarce one at that. Hence, if a company wanted to expand production, it needed a license to do so, which was not easily available. A market for licenses developed. Licenses had a price. Business competition under the License Raj meant getting licenses before your competitors. Often businesses acquired licenses not to produce but to stop the other from expanding. This is very bad, isn't it not? As Dhirubhai Ambani said, the art of managing government relationships was most critical to business success. The License Raj created a scarcity economy, and this scarcity also applied to foreign reserves since we practiced Swadeshi. The balance of payment crisis arose in 1970s and worsened towards the end of 1980s. The balance of payment situation came to the verge of collapse in 1991 mainly because the current account deficits were financed by borrowings from abroad. The economical situation of India was critical. The government was close to default. With India's foreign exchange reserves at US$1.2 billion in January 1991, and depleted by half by June, an amount barely enough to cover roughly 3 weeks of essential imports, India was only 2 weeks away from defaulting on its external balance of payment obligations. India was in the need of an International Monetary Fund bailout. The price of the bailout was the License Raj. 5:30 p.m. 24th July 1991, the Finance Minister of India, Dr. Manmohan Singh, presented the budget. He ended his speech with the historic lines, but as Victor Hugo once said, no power on earth can stop an idea whose time has come. The Indian economy started on a path of economic liberalization, which has eventually impacted each and every sector of the country and the life of every Indian citizen. Inflows of both foreign direct investment FDI and foreign institutional investment FII into India increased massively. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up, share, comment and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon. All video links are given in the description box.